Hi, I'm Jessica Carroll, and I'd like to welcome you to the Marine Fisheries Asian Growth Lab. Scientists in this lab work with other fisheries research sections here at the Institute to provide important data that help us to conserve Florida's fish populations. In this lab, we determine the ages of fish using a bone called the otolith. The otolith is found in the inner ear of a fish, and just like us, the fish use it for hearing and for balance. Unfortunately, removing the otolith is lethal because it's contained within the head of the fish, just behind the brain. Thankfully, approximately 70% of the otoliths that we use for age and growth analyses come from the fishery. That is to say that the fish was captured either by a commercial or recreational angler, and we were able to sample the fish and remove the otolith before the fish went to market or to the dinner table. The remaining 30% of otoliths that come to our lab for aging were captured using scientific sampling. These are often fish that are too big or too small to be captured within the fishery. The first step is extracting the otoliths from the head of the fish. The otoliths are then cleaned, dried, stored, and sent to our lab. We have Kristen Cook and Kristen Rynerson here today to walk you through the science of processing and aging otoliths.
First, we mark the core on the otolith. And then we hot glue that otolith to a piece of manila folder. The otolith is then taken to our multi-blade low-speed saw, which grinds through the bone and yields three cross sections at a time. Those sections are then placed on a microscope slide and are fixed to the slide using a liquid cover slip.
The prepared otolith slide is taken to the microscope where transmitted light shines through the thin section. We are able to count the dark bands, which are the annual growth rings, to determine the age of the fish, just like counting the rings on a tree.
Our Age and Growth Lab processes and ages about 30,000 otoliths per year from about 70 species of fish. These ages are combined with other data, including lengths, weights, reproductive information, mercury content, diet, and catch data. Our lab plays an important role in conserving Florida's fish populations because the ages we provide are critical to the stock assessment process. This is the primary source of information for management regulations. Age data are important because the lifespan of the fish is not the same across species. For example, here in Florida, spotted sea trout have been aged up to 10 years old, but their cousin, the red drum, have been aged up to 44. It's important that they aren't regulated the same. We also need to know how quickly fish grow, how big they are at certain ages, as well as the age structure of the population, that is, the number of fish at each age. These factors all go into the stock assessment process and management decisions for Florida's fish species, which is why the research that we do here in the Age and Growth Lab is so integral to the conservation process.